First off, I want to thank Mr. Dapperton for responding to me. He gave me a lot of exposure, most of it negative, but exposure is exposure and there's no such thing as bad publicity. So thank you. In exchange, you get this.
Now, this is epic.
Now, I was making that video for the fun of it and not really trying to debunk him. I actually never even watched his video before making a response. But I will make this specific video to respond him on one specific thing.
Don't we already have enough left-wing terrorists as it is?
Put it just on time!
Just to reiterate, this is not going to be the video about why I believe that a lot of left-wing violence is justified, or why I quote-unquote support terrorism. This is a video debunking the idea that the left is extremely violent, and that there's a lot of left-wing terror out there. And the reason I decided to attack this first is simply because of the fact that debunking him on anything else will need way more time for me to do. Anarchism and how it can't be viable with capitalism goes more deep into philosophy than I don't like government. So you guys will have to wait on those responses. While I'll admit Dapperton knows how to kill the anecdote game, I'm gonna have to say it, pointing out multiple one-off instances of left-wing violence is easy, especially if you're going to say that anyone disagreeing with Trump is left-leaning. Now in my video, I said there is rarely, if ever, such a thing as left-wing terror in America. It doesn't matter how many random instances of violence you can find in the news, that doesn't make it not rare. Something is rare if out of a whole it's not as prevalent. This method of posing data is called cherry-picking, where you start pointing out individual cases of something happening to prove a point, rather than what the actual data is showing. This...
What about the guy who had his truck burnt to a crisp because he had a Trump sticker on it? What about the other guy that I showed in the beginning where he had a Trump sticker and some black people just beat the shit out of him? What about Blair White when she got a drink thrown in her face for wearing a Trump hat and she didn't know what was in the drink? What about in Arby's when that little teenager was wearing that Trump hat and this big old socialist comes up and grabs the Trump hat and steals it and throws soda in his face? What about that autistic kid who wasn't even wearing Trump stuff? They just thought he was a Trump supporter, so they attacked him. They scalped him with a knife and tortured him for 4 days. What about at the vape shop when there was this Trump guy with a Trump shirt and the clerk wouldn't serve him, refused to serve him, and every time he tried to get him to serve him, he kept attacking him?
This is easy. Even I could do it. What with Nazis gathering and protesting during a pride parade, Charlottesville, the synagogue shooting, the killing of two black grandparents by a white supremacist who went on to say that whites don't shoot other whites, the bombs sent to Trump adversaries, the Dallas shooter that happened just yesterday, and I could keep going on and on, but I'm not interested in doing nothing more but throwing anecdotes around. I'm more interested in showing you data. Links to all of my research will be in the descriptions. So what does the data actually show? Well, it shows that when I say that the right wing has capitalized most of the violence in America and that the left wing violence is rare, it's true. The Cato Institute, a libertarian think tank funded by the Koch brothers, actually gives us the numbers when it comes to political violence in America. This graph came out in 2017 showing political violence from 1992 to 2017. Right now, we will ignore the Islamist terror because it would be dishonest of him or me to file it under left-wing or right-wing terror when both cases can be argued. And, well, why don't you look at that? The most murders in America based on ideology come from the right wing. But aren't I being dishonest by only talking about deaths? Well, 1 second, because the Cato Institute gave us a graph on injuries caused by certain ideologies. We'll once again be ignoring Islamist terror. And as you can see, yet and still, right-wing violence overtakes most of the violence compared to left-wing. Okay, so what about other sources? Why is the cutoff date at 1992? Well, I have no idea. So here's another graph going back to the 1970s. Seems like the left was very violent back in the 1970s, 80s, 90s, and early 2000s with more terrorist attacks. But over time, this left-wing violence has been lowering and lowering, so much so that now more violence than ever is committed by the right, especially in the last 2 years, which is where I was putting my focus. So left-wing violence exists, but that's never in contention. My point is that, for the most part, left-wing violence is pretty rare. And it is, and I think I've proven my point. Just in case you think I haven't made my point, here's more data. These are trends illustrating political violence from the left and right wing from early 2000s to 2017, and as you can see, left-wing violence is still extremely rare. So, quick update. As I was actually editing my video, I found that I completely forgot to tell you where the sources for the other two graphs came from, and it would be kind of dishonest for me to not tell you. The second one came from START, the National Consortium for the Study of Terrorism and Responses to Terrorism, and the second graph, the one with the trends, that one came from the Washington Post. Alright, links, as always, in the description. So if you think I actually haven't made my point, and that I've done nothing more than throw talking points at you, then tell me. My Twitter will be in the description for you to do so. Also, the comments exist. Please make sure to like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. Just so you guys know, this will be the last video I'll be uploading for a little bit because I have some family members to attend to. So y'all have fun, respond, I'll get back to you soon. Love you, and again, don't forget to subscribe, it really helps me out. See you guys later.